So why do you intend to be in front of the trading terminal? What is it that really motivates you to work in front of a trading terminal? Just if you can let me know. I really want to understand what is it that motivates someone to be a dealer. Because if you're trying to be in some place, you need to know what goes behind, right? So we'll get a chance to know a lot of technical analysis, right, about the market's volatility. Do you think a guy who is sitting across as a dealer is the guy who knows everything around technical analysis, or is the guy who gets to know a lot around technical analysis, right? So then what is the reason? Or if you're saying no, not at all, then what is the reason you want to be sitting across in front of the terminal and want to be a dealer? Ganesh, I didn't understand your statement. What to, but when to buy, right? So a guy who is in front of the trading terminal, he or she is basically, his or her major responsibility is what? It's to buy and sell, right? So buy and sell, whether you are into forex terminal or into equity terminal or whatever, right? It's buy and selling on the behest of someone, some of your customer asking you to take that trade, right? So it is not you who actually take those calls in terms of taking those trades, you know, right? So you are just doing it in behalf of what the client proposes. Yeah, now what the client may do is sometimes they may take your view, and you may have a view, obviously. This is your years of experience that's there. But then, please don't misunderstand me in terms of I'm not telling that you shouldn't be a dealer, but whatever profession you want to get into, you need to know the pros and cons, right? So, trading, sitting across as a dealer is a very, very strenuous exercise. It's quite stressful sort of an exercise, because within that amount of sound which goes out in that flow, right, when a lot of buying and selling actually is happening. So, and in that sort of an environment, you have to buy and sell. You have to be very cool and poised, and you shouldn't be like making any errors, right? And you have to be very careful around this set of things. So please go ahead and definitely try to be a dealer. Nothing bad in. I'm a trained forex dealer also, right? So I have seen that, and that's why I'm telling you. So just understand what is required in that sort of workplace, and whether your characteristics, your way of looking at life matches to that sort of a work environment, right? So don't make a mistake around that. That would be something which I would definitely suggest you. Was in an interaction in same and development in person, same person speaking, a dealer mostly approaches deals based on the company shape, right? So guys, what I'm trying to say, sometimes people make a mistake. People think is the dealer who is actually taking the calls, right? But that's not the case. They are doing it on behest of the customers. The other thing is that where you actually get to learn, or maybe something where you'd like to explore more, is on the research side of it, where the actual researching, where you are actually reading through different company details or economic details or industry details. I think that is a more fun element, right? So if you are thinking about that, but you believe that it's the dealer who does the stuff, dealer really doesn't get so much of time to actually do so much of research, right? So if your orientation is more towards research, then you have to think as to how I can get into the research side of it. So that is something which I'm trying to place across. Guys, voice is okay now. Just let me know. Yeah, Duncan, yeah, okay. Please tell me how to find the right part to choose an IBM 20%. So Akshit, join my those webinars, which in fact I have been sharing across the recordings of my previous webinar, where I speak as to how you should go about into investment banking. I'm not sure. Are you guys not going through those webinar recordings which I'm placing across? Are you not in the Facebook group or the WhatsApp group where I'm sharing all this? Just let me know. Please do that. This is for Akshit, right? So Ganesh, where the recordings are? So the recordings. So Akshit, please join the Facebook group and the WhatsApp group. I'll be sharing across the links today. So please join this group. There I'm sharing across the things. Telegram group, right? So any of the groups you join, and you'll be finding all the details over there, right? So guys, so let's start with what we have. Is the voice not? Is the voice okay now, guys? Someone is saying clear, Akshit. Volume is okay, right? Just write okay in the chat box if the volume is okay. Okay, right. Okay. So guys, thanks guys. So let's move into the section of discussion which I propose to do today. That is the 8 steps to financial analysis of any company. So whether you are trying to invest in the market by yourself, or you are trying to do it for any organization where you work, or in any context where you are trying to analyze, financially analyze a company, right? I think this is a very basic thing, and this has been one of the very important interview questions which I used to keep on asking to individuals, that suppose if I place across a company financial details, what are the things that you are going to see? I wanted some clarity in his thought in terms of what are the set of things he or she is going to be looking into, because it's a very basic question, isn't it? I'm sure you agree to the fact that this is a very basic question, that what one has to look into. I'm not saying just in terms of mota-mota ratios or something like that, but I'm trying to say in terms of what exactly in those financial statements that one has to look into, right? So Kulkarni, Karthik, I'm not saying income statement, cash flow statement. Please understand where I'm coming from. Usme kya dekhoge, right? Within income statement or cash flow statement or this thing, right? So people give very broad answers. That is precisely, that shows that the guy is not very clear in terms of what are those elements that one has to look into, right? So I think people get very mota-mota answer. They tell ways of liquidity, solvency, profitability. This is how we have studied in our college days, right? And that is what we tend to place across. But there is a way of putting across, and that is the thing that I propose to speak about today, right? So that you also, if you face a similar question, or these are the, I'm not saying what I'm going to discuss today is the whole and soul of what needs to be analyzed, right? Obviously not, because financial analysis go into a very deeper level. But then what is the first level of study that one needs to do? And that is precisely where I'm coming from, right? So let's start from there. So guys, I hope you are excited to learn about this. Just let me know. Are you excited? Give me a quick A in the chat box. Is it a good topic to discuss? Because I also keep on thinking that what are the things I should one has to be looking into, right? So let's move forward. So guys, now the fact that we are thinking about discussing how to go about undertaking financial analysis, so we need to understand what financial analysis aims to analyze, right? Again, someone is saying the volume is quite low. Is the volume not okay, guys? Just let me know. Perfect. Yeah, so most of the guys are saying it's clear, right? So what financial analysis aims to analyze, right? We need to first understand that. What are the few things what financial analysis help us do? So it helps us understand the amount of income the company earns in sells. It also tells about the amount of profits it is able to retain for shareholders. It tells about the sources of funds which a company has used for creating its assets. It also speaks about the amount of cash it generates from its operations and utilization of this cash, whether for investments and debt repayment. It also speaks about or aims to find companies which have a healthy financial position that can offer the potential for future growth, right? So these are the major objective with which a financial analysis exercise is undertaken, right? So that is the first thing, because if we are trying to do something, we need to understand why we are doing it in the first place, right? So just a second, this thing sometimes hangs up. Let's move forward from here, right? So guys, obviously when you're speaking about financial analysis, it obviously falls back on the financial statements. And as we know, there are three financial statements that we have: the balance sheet, profit and loss, and cash flow, right? So guys, in this entire financial analysis study that we do, there are two things which the entire study revolves around, right? One is the ratios, and the second is the growth rate. These are the two things which we need to see in context of financial analysis, right? And so guys, who had been a part of my webinar, the last webinar, I need to say, who has been a part of the last day's webinar? Arunava, yeah. Jay, Suparna, Payal, Akshay, yeah. So guys, thanks guys. So whoever has joined the last webinar, if you remember, I had shown to you a financial template, right? Where I showed you that if you just fill up those figures in the profit and loss, balance sheet and cash flow, all the ratios automatically get computed, right? Do you remember? Give me an A in the chat box if you remember that. Remember, right? Right. So that is one way through which you can really get across those ratio computation done for yourself, right? And so that is something which ideally is used for companies which are not listed or you do not get those details from some sources, right? There you can get the details from the organization and fill those details, and automatically everything is going to get computed, right? So the question is, what we do if we are having that same exercise to be done in context of a listed company, right? And whose details are actually, we get to find that, right? So obviously we need to have a system where we can get those financial data in matters of seconds, right? And automatically all those computations are done and stuff like that. So guys, who can tell me what is the way around for this? Anyone can tell me how you go about doing such an exercise if you're already undertaking that sort of an exercise, where you need the financial details of the companies, that means the balance sheet, cash flow, and this thing, and then all the ratios and all everything gets computed, right? So money control, annual reports of companies. So annual reporting of companies, though, Rahul, it is in hard copies, right? Money control can be one source. But I'm looking for some specific site which I'm going to show to you, and I'm just waiting for someone to place words on that. Yeah, so I have got the first one is Tejas Khatalik. Yeah, so he has mentioned Rahul in a form, but I want the exact site name. Whoever can place it across. Right, so there are different sources from where obviously you can get those details. But guys, the source which I would suggest you is something which is called screener.in, right? So this is a site, I hope you're able to see this, right? Or no, oh, just a second. I have to share the screen. So guys, this is the site called screener.in. So if you have not used this site, please do this, and I'll tell about certain features. So I discuss on this very in a detailed manner in my fundamental analysis program, right? But then I hope you are able to see it now. Guys, I hope you are able to see the screen. Yeah, right. So guys, the reason as to why, let me show you as to how you should be using it. So suppose if you are trying to get the details of, say, Reliance Industries, right? So you just place over there as Reliance Industries. Obviously, you need to sign in first, right? So over here, as you get to see that there are different, all these details about the company pops up, where you see the movement of stock and all those details, right? There is a peer comparison place also, where all the companies in the same industry, you get all the quarterly details, you get all the P&L, this thing you get, all the balance sheet, cash flow, ratio, shareholding pattern, everything you get, right? So guys, how many of you are getting to know about screener.in for the first time? Just give me an A in the chat box, guys. Just give me a quick A in the chat box. Kavita says A, Ganesh says A, Brahma says A, Payal says A, Opu says A, Abhishek says A, Jyoti says A, Tejas says A, Ankit says A, Raj says A, right? So guys, Rajesh B, means you are knowing about screener.in? Yeah, that's good. It's similar to Money Control Value Research. Yeah, so there are sites, but there is a specific thing around screener.in, which is something which I really like, which I'll share across with you. Can you guys tell me what is very, why screener.in is something which is very good, which really is something that makes it very different? There are various sources from where you can get a lot of financial information. The question is not that. We can export financial data in Excel. That is one part of it. What's the next level of it? Search by sector, okay. Yeah, there are sector-wise searches that you can do. Personalized data can be obtained according to needs. Right, so when you say, okay, so I think that when you have taken my program, I think from there you must have learned, right? So what is, it will have annual reports as it is. Is it? So Tejas, if you want the annual report as it is, you can go to any company's website, and in the investor section, you can get it over there, right? But so guys who are not familiar with screener.in, let me first tell them as to how this is so good, right? So guys, so suppose if you have got Reliance Industries Limited over there, so there is a feature called Export to Excel, right? And once you click over here, this is something like this that drops up. And I'll show it to you, so that this is not in context of Reliance, but the company called Avanti Feeds, okay? Now, this is something like this you will get to find when you click on Excel, something around like this will drop up in front of you. So you have profit and loss figures of the respective years. You have the quarterly level of analysis. You have the balance sheet over there, balance sheet details. You have the cash flow over there. And there is something called the customization and something called the data sheet, right? So guys, this is one level of information that you get to hold, get to know, right? This is good. But where screener.in really takes it to the next level is that whatever details that you get over here, obviously you would be looking for certain computations to be done. So some ratios that you need to calculate, or some growth, something that you want to analyze, right? So they won't give you those calculations. But the thing is that you can go about doing those calculations in the sheet, right? The only thing that you need to do is you don't touch the data sheet, but you can go about doing the calculations, right? And I'll show you, this is the type of a sheet, right? So as you see over here, I've done different nature of calculations over here, right? So this is something which I've done on the data sheet, which was placed across, right? So I've done that stuff. Now, the question is, or the good thing about this is that what you can do is if you go to screener.team/excel and you upload that sheet where you have done those computations and upload it over there. So next time for any company you want to analyze and get the computation, means the data which is computed, right? Not just only the data, but a computed data, this is the way you want it. You can upload it over here. And next time when you click on export to Excel, that is the format in which you'd be getting those facts and figures, right? So did you get it, guys? Did you get the essence of what I tried to say? Right? Nitin says, wow. Customized format. Yeah. Malcolm Miranda, yeah. So this is, guys, this is something which really makes life very easy. So if you're trying to do investing on your own, right? And you want to do analysis of different companies. So if you have that format ready, so you can do the computation in a matter of seconds, right? You get the sheets all computed at your end, right? And then it makes your life easy in terms of how you want to analyze the stuff. And other than that, you also have over here, as you go below, please, I would definitely ask you guys to go to screener.in at your own time, right? At your own, whenever you have time. So there is something called the query builder over here. So whenever you think about investing in any company, there are certain parameters which you think are, if this sort of thing fits in, then is the, I'd be looking for that sort of a company I'd be trying to identify those companies who are having those parameters, right? So there is a query builder sort of a stuff over here. I'm losing out over here, but that's not the objective. You can find it out by yourself. So there are a lot of things which really is very good in screener.in, and this is something which I would definitely like you guys to go and do for yourself, right? One more time, I mean, the sheet we uploaded, Screener will give in the same format next time. Absolutely, Abhishek. That is precisely what I said, right? Right, guys? So guys, I hope this is something which is really exciting, right? So this makes our life simple. Abhi kya hai ki abhi hume wo janna hai ki which are those set of aspects which we should look forward to in terms of analysis, and why and what are the best practices around that, right? So that it makes our life simple. It helps us do the analysis fast and in a simple manner, right? So, right. So guys, I hope it is clear till this point of time, and just give me a quick A in the chat box if it is absolutely fine, right? So guys, there are a lot of people today, so I would expect at least an A to be typed in the chat box. So Rajesh, for unlisted company, obviously you have to reach out to the companies and ask for the financial details, right? And there are some databases like CMIE and all, I think they also have a section where unlisted the company database is there, right? So you have to reach out to those sources, right? Publicly, I'm not very sure, Rajesh, as is valuation method. Yeah, so valuation method is different, but we can search over here, say State Bank of India, right? So we have banking over here as well, right? Tejas, banking details we have, and valuation, the technique is different, obviously, but that is not what the topic of discussion over here today is. The objective is just, let us not get into the banking side of discussion, right? Let us focus into the more relevant sort of companies which you get to understand, and the basic set of analysis which we can do for mostly the companies which we generally come across, right? Yeah, that, but that's a very pertinent point which Tejas has placed across, that when we do analysis for banking, it gets to a different, it is done in a different way, right? When you are going through the, because the balance sheet and the financial statements of a bank is different from that of normal companies, right? Normally, I mean to say, say a manufacturing enterprise or a trading enterprise, right? So there, the thing is done in a different way. And so I'll then, in fact, that's a good thing that you reminded, Tejas. I'll try to do some, means a webinar especially into that, right? How to study the banking companies. But for now, I hope this one is clear for many individual. I think they were not exposed to Skinner.in. Help us in the website. Pelani Savi, as I mentioned, that for unlisted companies, you have to reach out to them directly, right? Or maybe you may try to access their website, and there may be investor relations section from where you can download. Or there may be certain databases like CMIE and all, where you may be getting those data elements, right? So so that's the way, not that I know of, where we can get on some website, right? So if you guys like to get to know, let me know about it as well. But when we used to fall back on CMI databases, and where they had a section for unlisted companies as well, right? So guys, let's move forward from here. I think this you understood. So this, as I said, it's a matter of seconds with which you can collect this data, right? Now, obviously, the next section that we need to focus on is now the fact that we have got the data elements. Obviously, now we need to analyze the company, right? And guys, what I'm going to say today is not something out of the world, right? I'm trying to give you simple 8-step method, that which as a first level of looking into financial statements, you have to be taking cognizance of, right? Because what happens, there are so many ratios and so many financial data points which make people confused in terms of bhai first level mein main kya dekhu agar mujhe dekhna ho ki first level mein main ye sare parameters agar ho to I will go ahead with this company or else. So it's a method of filtration, right? And then we'll go later into the other levels of operating efficiency and stuff like that, which comes later, right? So I hope Priyanka, I didn't understand your question. What is WIS? Just let me know, right? So guys, excited to see, this is my view, right? And there may be difference in opinions, but what I'm trying to place over here is that, okay, wholly owned subsidiary. Yeah, then in that case, maybe, right? But I'm saying on a standalone basis, not that I know of where you can get it on the website part of it, right? So I'm trying to give you a filler in terms of these are the 8 steps which you need to look into for analyzing a company, right? So let's move on with the first one. But before that, guys, many of you have a question as to how to read an annual report, right? Because that is something which I think which everyone should know. So I have some perspective as to how one should go about reading an annual report, because that's a very good exercise. See, one thing is you are getting the data and you are analyzing the financials basis the computation that is getting done, right? But you need to understand the story behind those numbers, right? That is very important. And for that, the more you read through annual reports and make it a practice for yourself to read through annual reports in details, it's going to be very good, and it also gives you a lot of understanding and exposure around the different industries and what how the business model works for a company, right? And I always suggest, please read through annual reports of Infosys, right? That is one of the best annual reports they come up every year with, right? So if you want to develop the taste, if you are not in a habit of reading annual reports and you want to develop a taste of reading annual reports, I would suggest you that start with Infosys. Go to their website, download the 2, 3, 4 years of annual reports, go through each of the reports. And I suggest you, you say 4 years back, say 2017, you start. Right, so go through the 2017 one first, then 2018. Then you will see how they have changed over the years, how their business model have changed, what objectives, right, what objective that they have set for themselves, and how they have made those objectives, how things have flowed from them over, flowed for them over the years. Right, so that would be great. Right, and if you guys would be interested in my perspective as to how you should go about reading an annual report, so you can go to my YouTube channel, and I'm sharing this with everyone. So you can copy paste this, and you can go and go through this YouTube channel whenever you find time. Right. So a little late in joining, we'll be getting no Bhuvan. The PPT is not shareable. Right. So. So guys, I hope it's fine till this point of time. Let me know if it is okay till this point of time. I hope you are give me a quick A in the chat box, right? Learning something. Because see, financial analysis, I'm pretty sure you guys are doing, and many guys are also working in the organizations who are doing it on a day-to-day basis, right? So I was a bit apprehensive whether I should really take up this subject. But then I thought about, because I have found very less number of guys who have a very clear way of placing across that these are the, as per me, these are the 5, 6, 7, 8 steps that I'd be going through if I've been given the financial details. These are the set of things that we're going through. And I think that is something which is the bare minimum which should be expected from an individual to know, right? So so if you guys have never thought about it or were not prepared on that, so that is why I am conducting this right now, that, right? So, so guys, let's move to the way we should be analyzing. So guys, so there are, as you know, there are three types of financial statements, right? Profit and loss, balance sheet, and cash flow, right? So as I said, there are two aspects whenever you are analyzing something. There are two types of aspects which generally we fall back on. One is the growth aspect, how much things have grown over a period of time, or the different ratios that we compute, right? So I'll take you in terms of profit and loss, balance sheet, and cash flow. What are the elements that you should look into? So I am, this is taken from actual data, but then I'm not really placing across the name of the company, because that is not important. The, what is important is what are the set of things that you need to look into. So as you see over here in this, I hope you're able to see, just let me break that. So over here, as you see, the first thing to check is whether there's a growth in sales of the company in the past, right? So companies that has a product or service which is high in demand usually shows high growth in sales in the past. So the company over here has grown from 2469 in 2011 to 5511 in 2020, which turns out to be a compounded annual growth rate of 9% year on year. So guys, whoever have no understanding as to how to compute a CAGR, please do some Google Googling, and you'll get to know. Right. So guys, what as an investor, what one should be looking at is that investors should prefer companies that have grown at least at a rate of inflation of more in the past. Right. So because if a company has not grown beyond the inflation growth rate, then it doesn't make much sense. Right. So as an investor, you should see to the fact that the CAGR in which the company has grown should be greater than the inflation rate which is standing at this point of time, right? And the other thing is that one should note that very high growth, suppose if it is showing a growth rate of say greater than 50% or so, then you have to be very cautious around this set of companies, because it may not be sustainable in the long run, right? So then either you really need to dig deep in terms of what this company is facing across, which as a result of which there is no competition, or they are doing something extraordinarily good, right? You really need to dig deep into it. But if it is very high also, what I'm trying to say, you have to be cautious. And obviously, if it is lower than the inflation rate, then it doesn't make much sense, right? This Abhishek, I'm speaking about sales growth. So it's mentioned over here, Abhishek Singh, right? Where inflation would mean that the company's number plus are same, right? The revenue has increased just because of cost of turnover. So Bhuvan, the thing is that, yeah, so in a way you may think it in that manner, right? Right, yeah. So I hope this is clear, guys. Just let me know if this is clear. I'll try to take you slow, but slow and steady, right? Give me an A in the chat box if you have understood till this point of time. It's a very basic thing, right? But then this is obviously the first element in a PNL statement that you have to look. Ye kitna badh raha hai, iska growth rate kitna hua hai over a period of time, and whether it is higher than the inflation rate over these years. And if it is too high, then what is the reason as to why it is so high? Because and if you are not in a real position to understand about the company in depth, in terms of understanding their business model, right? Because so then you should avoid those companies. Like Warren Buffett says that when these e-commerce companies and all these companies came up, he also says that he didn't have understanding much about this company, so he was not eager to invest on those companies. He only invest on those companies which he understands, right? So in a similar manner, if you also have to understand as to which company you should be investing in and their business dynamics very well, right? So this is the first point which I wanted to place across. The second aspect which you need to focus on is, this is also around P&L, right? The second is profitability, right? Now guys, there are, no HP, I'm not sure what's the name is, but it's not a paid version of, I don't remember I paid anything. I don't think it's paid, right? Jay, in what context you are asking this question? Was it Walmart? No, it is about the e-commerce, the Amazon or so, those set of companies. I think you are asking this in context of investment that Warren Buffett does, right? So, and guys, in this context, let me tell you, if you can get hold of there is a series of letters which Warren Buffett have placed over the years, right, to their shareholders. Right, Berkshire Hathaway, they have released a lot of series of letters. So if you can, I think that is available over the net. And if you can get hands to those set of letters, please have a read on that. It's something really interesting to study along, right? So please do that. Now guys, the second one was the sales growth that we have seen. The second is profitability, right? Now, as we know, there are two types of profitability where one should be focusing on. One is the operating profit margin, OPM, and the other is the net profit margin, right? So if you are trying to get this computation done, you can go about doing that. But where I'm trying to discuss it more is in terms of the fact that, see, operating profit margin, as we understand, is a measure the portion of sales income that is remaining after deducting cost of producing the sales. There's raw material cost, employee cost, sales and marketing cost, power and fuel cost and all. And operating profit does not factor in expenses like depreciation of fixed assets, interest and tax expenses. Also, we do not include non-operating other income while calculating operating profit. See, I'm not trying to teach here as to how to compute something, but how to analyze it, right? So this is just to give sense as to what we are speaking about. So net profit margin replaces the net profit that the company that remains after the company has paid its interest, tax, and factoring depreciation. Net profit is final remnant after meeting all expenses and is available within the company for reinvesting. Right. So an investor's aim is to find companies with good profitability, which they have been able to sustain in the past. So it's very important that the set of company that you are trying to invest in should have been able to sustain a good profitability in the past, right? And companies with high profit margins are able to face tough times comfortably and still make money for their shareholders. So considering that, if we move backwards, so we see over here in terms of the profit margin, as we see, it has sustained around over 14, 16, 17%, 15%, right? So 14 to 17% had been the range over the years. And the net profit margin has also been in the range of 7 to 10%, right? So the next thing which we need to see is find companies with good profitability, which they have been able to sustain in the past. And obviously you need to also match it out with the industry, right? So in that sort of industry, the set of companies which are taken up, right? And if you have gone through my webinars where which I've done on biscuit manufacturing company or the hotel industry. There is one more which I have done, which is on the industry. So I've shown it over there as to why we do the industry analysis, right? And how we take a set of companies and find the median value of those different ratios and the different margin computations and stuff like that, right? So you can take now a reference from there and try to understand that. One is how sustaining this profitability had been over a period of time, and obviously how the company has been performing vis-a-vis the industry performance, right? So this is something that you have to look into, right? So guys, I hope it's clear till this point of time. Just let me know if there is any question. I hope you are getting it, right? It's nothing, no major deal, but I hope I'm able to make sense to you. Give me a quick A in the chat box, guys, if you're finding value in terms of what I'm placing across. Someone is saying voice is not clear. My only objective is to tell you that if someone asks you this question, you have to be very clear in terms of these are the broader heads which I would be looking into if I am given a financial statement, right? Ho sakta hai ki aapke samne ek aisa Excel sheet place kiya gaya in the interview and you are made to say that this is what the figures are and how will you analyze this company? What is your view around this company? And I've seen many people, they give bada bada gyan, leverage, ye wo, efficiency ratios and this ratio, that ratio, right? But simple things like this, they do not speak about, and they do not have a hierarchy in which the discussion is taken forward, right? So that is the objective with which I'm speaking today. So guys, I hope there is no question. So I'm moving to the next one. So we have spoken about the sales growth, then came the operating margin, profit margin. Okay, there is something which is still elevated over. Discuss. So we can see that the operating profit margin for this, okay, Supreme, it is of Supreme Industries, sorry. I didn't want to mention the name of the company. So it was around 14 to 16%, right? And the net profit margin in the company is stable in the range of 8 to 10%. So an investor should prefer companies that have stable or improving profit margin over the companies with declining or fluctuating profit margin, where the company may see profits in some years and losses in other years. So this is something which as an investor you should look at. And also you should see into the fact, right, that methods where there's sometimes companies resort to different methods to inflate profits, right? And which includes like playing around with expenses, playing around with profits and losses from investments, not making expenses that they are required to do, or changing accounting policies whenever it suits them, right? So this falls under your different red flags which one needs to study. In fact, whoever takes my investment banking suit program, there's a separate program which discuss around the red flags in business. So where I discuss in very detailed manner as to what are the different techniques which companies resort to play around with their numbers and the financial statements, right? So this may not be a set of things which you can look at the first stage, right? But I'm just placed it across so that you can keep that as something which we need to see through at a later point of time when we have analyzed those first level of companies and then when we want to dig deep into those companies, right? So that's the objective. Then the third element, guys, is the element of tax, right? So over here, if you see that a company with good accounting and corporate governance standards would want to pay all legitimate taxes to the government, right? So generally, the corporate tax rate is 30% for Indian companies and 40% for foreign companies. So abnormally low tax payout should raise red flags and must be analyzed. So we need to have a thought as to if we see that the tax which is paid is very low, then it's a question that has to come up in our mind as to why the taxes that is getting to be shown over here is so low, right? So we can see the company has been paying tax mostly at the rate of corporate tax. In 2020, the tax payout ratio has declined because of changing the corporate tax rate in India. And payment of taxes at the rate of corporate tax rate is a healthy sign. In case an investor notices that a company has its tax payout ratio lower or higher than the standard corporate tax rate, then he or she should read the annual report of the company in detail to find out the reasons for the difference in tax rate, right? So there may be various reasons as to why the tax rate may fluctuate, right? So there may be many reasons. So few of the reasons, like most of the times, a lower taxpayer ratio may be linked to the following reasons. So there may be tax incentives available to the company due to operations in SEZ. Maybe the company falls into SEZ for which they have some tax incentives or export incentives provided by the government, or tax-free income like interest on the investment done by company in tax-free bonds, or income that is taxed at a lower rate like short-term capital gains on investments like stock. And so what I'm trying to say, guys, is in essence that you have to get to understand as to why the tax is getting to be way lower or higher, right? If that sort of a standard we are able to see. Guys, is it making sense? Is it slowly building up for you? Just give me a quick A in the chat box. I hope, because today I was a bit apprehensive that whether people would be liking it or not. So I hope. Should we use tax and P&L or taxing? So this is something which we are speaking in context of P&L, Nitin, right? So this is in context of P&L, yeah. So Tejas, the thing is, I would suggest please write down this set of things. One is that, and second is when I share the recordings, you can go through it again and take notes of this. And the other thing is that, but still I suggest everyone to join the webinar live, because going forward I'll be sharing something every webinar, and that is a sort of a motivating factor for someone to join the webinar, right? So it's only for guys who would be joining the webinar and be doing something which I'll tell you to do, right? So that would be the essence. So guys, I hope you are finding it good. So let's move forward. So we have reached to three elements, right? We have discussed on the sales growth. We have discussed on the profitability in terms of operating profit margin and net profit margin. And the third is the tax rate, right? Now, the other element which you should look into is the interest coverage part of it, right? So Bhuvan, higher won't be the it won't be that someone is paying a higher tax rate. Obviously there would be reasons for lower tax rate, but in certain occasions they may have in a particular year may have earned more than what they have been doing over the years. Maybe that may be the reason, or some computation error has taken place something of that sort, right? To be very frank, that is not something which is really coming to our mind at this point of time, but these are something which we can look into, right? So the fourth element is the interest coverage part of it. So interest coverage, as you know, indicates whether its operating profits generated by the company are sufficient to pay interest to lenders for the fund it has borrowed from. So investors should look out for companies that have interest coverage of at least 3. So it implies that they make an operating profit of at least 3, whereas the interest expense is 1. Higher interest ratio provides a cushion during bad economic times, and the company would not find it difficult to service its debt even during bad times, right? So I hope this is the sense which many people have, but still I wanted to reiterate on that the operating profit should be at least 3 times than that of the interest which they are due to pay, right? So that is something which one has to look into, the interest coverage part. But while calculating, where this something that we need to be taken care of is that while calculating the interest coverage ratio, an investor should keep in mind that the interest expense shown in P&L statement is after deducting the capitalized interest, right? So the capitalized interest is that portion of the total interest which the company pays on the debt taken for construction of plant and machinery. Until the plant is operational, a company can capitalize the interest on the debt taken for the construction of the plant. As a result, the interest expense in the PL may not represent the company's interest outflow of the company in any year, right? So to mitigate this issue in our analysis, we assume a sample interest rate and calculate the interest outflow for the company in any year based on the assumed rate. So it's 10%, I'll get back to the table again. Therefore, we calculate the interest coverage ratio by dividing the operating profit with this interest outflow, which gives us a more realistic figure. So I hope you are getting the sense that there is something which we as interest get to see in the P&L statement, but there may be some element of interest which is getting capitalized, right? So we have to take that into consideration over here to get a true figure of things. So over here, as you see, operating profit and interest expense, that is there, right? But if we are trying to understand that what may be an interest outgo for the company, so you have to take an assumed rate of say 10%, And you have to then do this computation, right? 10% of 514 is 51, or 351 is 35, right? And then calculate the interest coverage on ALCO A by F, and that is how you have to take this into consideration, right? So that will give you a better picture around the set of things. Got it? So next we'll speak about the DE ratio. We'll get into the balance sheet part of it. I hope it's clear till this point of time, guys. Is it clear till this point of time? No, so you have to take, Ganesh, you have to calculate the interest outgo figure, like the way I showed. Right, so right, guys, thanks for the responses. So Avitak, these are the I think four elements we saw into, right? So these are the elements we have to see in context of P&L, right? Now let's move into the balance sheet part of it. So next is the balance sheet part of it, where we get to calculate the debt to equity ratio, right? So over here, as you see over here, the debt to equity ratio measures the composition of firms that a company has utilized to buy its assets. The company uses its assets to produce goods and services that bring sales revenue to the company. So DE ratio shows how much of the total funds employed by the company is its own. We know what DE ratio is, right? So DE of 1 means that 50% of the funds are bought by shareholders and the rest is borrowed from the lenders. So this is what DE is about. But so during bad times, the company might not be able to make good profits. The lender will ask for the money and the company might have to sell its assets in distress to pay back the lenders. If the company is not able to find buyers willing to pay sufficient money, it can become bankrupt. Therefore, investors should prefer companies with low debt to equity ratio. Guys, please understand that what I'm stressing over here is that it is preferable to get into investing into companies which have a low debt to equity ratio, right? But it doesn't mean that a company should have zero debt, right? Because if a company has is not in a obviously it also depends on the nature of company, what are their objectives and how they visualize the company growing over a period of time. There are a lot of things that come into consideration, but still I would say that you need to understand what is the industry dynamics around the debt structure, which I have shown in my webinars also, where I've discussed around different industries. So you need to understand the debt structure of that particular industry, and it is not necessary that the it has to be zero. But if it is on the lower side, the better it is. That means that the company is not, it won't be in a major challenge if that sort of a situation, if any year it gets to be bad for the company for any specific reason, right? So some investors like to use only secured or long-term debt for calculating D/E ratio. However, taking total debt for calculating is preferable. So this is something which I've been following over the years, right? But now each one has a, see, every ratio that you get to calculate, there are a lot of debate and discussion as to what you take in the numerator, what you take in the denominator. But there are certain standardized elements which are there, but there's still many people hold a lot of debate discussion as to how it gets computed. So that's why, guys, whoever has taken my program, please follow the financial template thing which I have shared with you guys, which I showed in the last webinar. If you follow that structure and how it's getting computed, how the ratios are getting computed over there, that is a good place where you can get it validated, how it's getting computed, right? No, Tejas, it's only for those guys who have taken my program. So it's for them. Cost of capital is less for debt, so better ROC can be there if debt is there. Yeah, that can be a way of looking into that, Bhuvan, definitely. So there is no ideal debt to equity ratio. As I said, Rajesh, you need to match it up with the industry standards. If you have not gone through my webinars, the industry-based webinars which I've done, please go through the recordings of that, because there I've shown how what are the different financial aspects that you need to compute at an industry level to get a sense as to what is happening in that industry and what is the best practice in that industry, right? So that will give you, so Rajesh, there are webinars on hotel, five-star hotel industry. There's something around the biscuit manufacturing company. And there is one more thing I'm forgetting. One more industry-based webinar I've done. I'm forgetting the one. Guys, Moise and all, I think, just if you can make me remember which is the one which I'm missing out. No, I've not done on telecom, but there's one which I'm missing out. Just check it out. Rajesh, are you there in my Facebook group and WhatsApp group? And I'm getting power industry, right? Nitin, right? So it's power industry that I've done. So, right. Abhishek Moise, right. So that will give you a sense as to how these things are done. Right. So guys, I hope it's okay till this point of time. I hope you are getting some value, learning something. So you only have stated the reason, Savi, as to why generally company goes for a lesser debt, right? I don't understand what you mean by the other side of the coin. I really don't understand, because you have given the reasons yourself, right? So guys, over here at this juncture, I would like you to, whoever is joining my webinars, just to appreciate the fact that you are joining the webinar. I'll be sharing something which is going to be of immense help to you. So today I'll be sharing. So my request would be that you go to this LinkedIn site of mine and place a comment as to what has been your learning today like in once you go over here. I'll stop for 3-4 minutes out here, and whoever is going to be sharing some feedback, I will be. And the other thing that you do, please, if you're not connected to me directly, place a connect with my profile, and then I'll be sharing across this assumption sheet of a 5-star hotel. So I always keep on saying the more assumption sheets you see, the more better you get an understanding as to how detailed, in a detailed manner, as to how the entire business model works, right? So I'll keep on sharing that sort of stuff. My reasons to offer data, I'm asking, is the company want to become, okay, other way around, to become debt free. So see, the only logic which at this point of time, which is coming to my mind, Savi, is that you do not have the risk, right? So tomorrow, if some unforeseen thing happens, there are many situations which is not within the control of the company, right? So it may be in context of, say, the economic challenges, or maybe something, say something like a COVID situation takes place, right? So the company cannot do much. And in this sort of a situation, if you have a fixed interest to be paid, then it has a lot of pain for the company, right? To avoid that sort of a situation, people resort to, and resort to this thing, debt-free sort of a situation. Right, so it's majorly from a risk perspective, I would say. So guys, I hope you have got it. So I hope you are going onto LinkedIn and just place a few words as to how your experience has been till this point of time. Obviously, I'm going to share once you come back, I'm going to share many more things, right? And whoever is going to place a comment, see, I'm not saying place a good comment, whatever is, whether it's good, bad, whatever, just place a comment in the LinkedIn, and whoever does that, I'll share across this assumption sheet. So this is a way for me to encourage people to join the webinars, because if you are there, then it makes sense for me to conduct the webinar in the first place, because you ask questions, I revert to that. Otherwise, I would have just made, I would have just done a video and would have uploaded it. Right, I'll let you know, HP, just hold back. Right, thanks, Moise. So guys, I'll just take a break for 3 minutes, right? And I'll join. In the meantime, you can go to LinkedIn and place a comment. Yeah, hey guys, I'm back. So thanks for those who have commented. I'll be sharing with you this Excel sheet, assumption sheet of a 5-star hotel as soon as this gets on, right? I hope who had commented the last time has also got, it is just to give you that sort of motivation to join the webinars, because otherwise the objective of joining the webinar gets defined in the first place, right? So Abhishek, what I'll do is I'll respond to your question at a later point of time, right? See, the thing is, I believe in one thing, that if you have this thing, if you have the practical skill sets, then everything is fine, right? So that's about it. Right, guys, so let's move forward. So we have discussed on the various elements till debt equity at this point of time. So let's move forward. Guys, are you guys there? Just give me a A in the chat box. Let's again. Let's again start, right? So guys, the next aspect of the is the current ratio, right? So this is also, which is very important. So as you see over here, current assets. So we know this current assets and current liabilities is just for people who may be from non-finance sort of background. So at least over here. So the essence is current ratio greater than one means the company has current CA, which exceeds current liabilities, and that the company would be able to pay off its near-term liabilities, right? So an investor should look for companies that have current ratio of more than 1.5. So this is something please. And if you go to different, they have their own standard space in terms of what should be the current ratio and stuff like that. But a current ratio of 1.25, so that means you have that 25% margin, right? That's the reason it is generally preferred. So that is in context of the current ratio. So the next section where we are focusing on is analysis of cash flows, right? So we have spoken about what to see in the P&L statement. We have seen what to see in the balance sheet, right? Now we are moving into the cash flows statement. Now guys, in cash flow, there are three parts to it: CFO, cash flow from operations, cash flow from investments, and cash flow from financing activities, right? So we know what CFO, CFI, CFF stands for. But that is not what I'm trying to discuss over here. But why I'm trying to bring your focus is that as an investor, you should focus on companies which generate a good amount of cash flow from operations that can take care of the requirements of CFI and repayment of debt, that is CFF. So if you go back, as you see over here, that cash flow from operations is how much? 170. And cash flow in investing, so they have invested 240. This is the investment. And they have earned how much? So financing activity. So over here, they have repaid. The ones in red is the one that they have repaid, or this is a borrowing that has, this is a positive inflow, right? So as you see, in most of the cases, it has been that it is positive. The net cash outflow is, the net cash flow is positive. So that gives a feeling that whatever they are earning, so basis that earning, they are able to pay for those investment activities in the company, or maybe they are able to repay back the money which they have taken on loans for the different investments that they have, right? So if that sort of a situation is there, that's the best situation that may take place. So if an investor can find a company that generates so much cash that take care of both CFI and CFF, it still has surplus debt, that's a great situation. So we can see that a company has been generating a good amount of cash from operations year on year. We can observe that throughout the last 10 years, the company was expanding its manufacturing capacity as reflected negative cash flow from investing, which we saw in that chart. However, almost all the money for investment in the plant and machinery has been generated from its operations. This is because the cash inflow on the CFO of the company has been considerably higher than the cash outflow on the CFI. So as a result, an investor can appreciate that the surplus CFO left after taking care of the outflow on the CFI has been used by the company to pay dividends to shareholders as well as to repay off the debt. But I hope the most important sentence over here is that if the cash flow from operations is taking care of the CFI and CFF, that's the best scenario that may happen, and that is the sort of company which should be eyeing for, right? So so this is the one around CFI, CFO, CFI, and CFM, right? Now, one more thing, let me teach you in terms of there's something called cumulative PAT versus cumulative CFO. And this is a computation which many people don't do, right? And what you have to do over here is that the net profit after tax, which is there, you just add it, right? Say it is 3,333, and the cash flow from operations, you just add it. It is 4,215. And then you do a competitive study over there. And why we are doing it? Because a company that sells any product today might not receive its payment immediately. However, it is legitimately eligible to receive it. Therefore, accounting standards allow it to report the sale and its profit in the P&L. However, the money received from the buyer will be reflected in CFO only when the money is actually received from the buyer. Therefore, if we compare PAT and CFO for 1 year, they would differ from each other. However, after a long time, cumulative PAT and CFO should be similar, right? So if cumulative PAT is similar to CFO, it means that the company is able to collect its profits in actual cash from its buyers. If CFO is abysmally lower than PAT, it would mean that either the company, though legitimately eligible to receive money from the buyer, is not able to collect it, or the profits are fictitious. In either case, the situation is not correct, right? So this is a sort of a study which you can do it, and I think this is something which one should be doing it, right? And that is why we have placed it over here. Right, guys? So did it... some more things. So a company that sells any product today might not receive... Okay. Sorry, it is the same thing out there. Right? So I think you got it, guys. Let me know if you have got this interpretation of CFO, cumulative PAT and cumulative CFO. Did you get it clearly? I think many people have not heard about this, or many people don't know about this, right? That there is something that something of this nature which has to be looked into. So there are much more things in depth which one has to look into, which I've discussed in detail in my fundamental analysis program, which is there, right? So that's there, but this is the first level of thing which one should be really aware of. So but PAT and CFO apart from data source differ due to DNA. Bhuvan, it is mota. Please understand, it is just to give you the intuitive sense as to it. Don't get too specific around numbers, right? We are not into accounting, we are into finance. Please understand that, right? So don't get too hassled around numbers as to how to compute and all. If you are getting a sense, ye mota aisa ho raha hai, so you are trying to get a pillar. See, on the basis of this only, you are not going to take a decision whether we are going to invest in a company, right? And as I'm saying, I'm showing you 8 main aspects which you should add. Koi agar aapke samne ek financial statement diya, ye mota cheez main dekhunga as the first step. Aaj mera sirf wahi maksad hai, so that you guys can, if tomorrow you are asked in an interview, ये बेसिक क्वेश्चन का आंसर दे नहीं पाता है, और आदमी भी सोचता है मुझे नौकरी क्यों नहीं मिला. और सब बड़े बड़े, आई हैव सीन मेनी चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स, मेनी सीएफएस, मेनी एमबीएस नॉट बीन एबल टू आंसर दिस बेसिक क्वेश्चन. दे से अ लॉट ऑफ, मतलब बार बार रेशियोज सुनाता रहता है मुझे, राइट? बट ये कौन कौन सा चीज आप देखोगे, इसका क्लैरिटी नहीं है. So आई होप यू आर गेटिंग द एसेंस व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू प्लेस अक्रॉस, दैट दिस इज जस्ट अ फर्स्ट लेवल चेक. ऑब्वियसली और क्या डीपर देखा जाता है, we'll discuss it sometime later. But is this that also by itself is possible? It will be safe, is much more cumulative pair. Okay. That may happen, right? The cash flow from operations. Nitin, thoda soch ke bolna padega. I don't want to hurry up and give an answer to this. I have not thoda isko sochna padega. If payables is increasing, yeah, that may be a situation. So we need to understand which are those situations when this sort of a thing may ideally take place. But over here, the objective is just to like trigger your thought in this set of pointers which you need to think on. Right. So guys, till now, whatever we have discussed, so we already have discussed on this 8 pointers. I'm missing Amit today, you know, especially Moiz and all who joins on a regular basis. So we have discussed on sales growth, the 8 points, which includes, which we have discussed is sales growth. So look for high and sustainable growth rate greater than 15% per year is good. And the growth rate of greater than 50% is unsustainable long term. Look for a high and sustainable OPM and NPM. NPM of greater than 8% is preferable. Tax payout ratio should be near to the general corporate tax rates, unless some specific tax incentives are applicable to the company. Interest coverage, look for companies with an interest coverage of greater than 3. Debt to equity ratio, look for companies with low or nil debt, preferably debt to equity should be less than 0.5. Current ratio, look for companies with CR greater than 1.25. Cash flow, positive CFO is necessary. It's great if CFO means the outflow for CFI and CFF. And cumulative PAT per cumulative CFO, look for companies where PAT and CFO are similar for the last 10 years. Right? So these are the 8 points, guys. Agar koi bole ki at a glance kya kya cheez dekhoge, and if you are able to enumerate in this manner, that these are the, I think this is going to be a great impression that you are going to place across in front of the recruiter or the interview, right? So guys, let me know, did it add value today? Was it good? Give me a quick A in the chat box if you got value in this. Priyanka says A, Superda says A, Moe says A, Mon says A, yes, Kavita says 4A, Mon says A, absolutely good. It's a website where we can find all the materials. So HP, you can refer to ibef.org. That's a site which you can fall back on, ibef.org. Get the response. So Mansi, I'll be sharing this recording over my Facebook group. I'll share. So what I do is let me share across with you the. If you are not part of the WhatsApp group, please join the WhatsApp group and the. Just give me a minute. So this is the this thing. Your WhatsApp, if you want to join my WhatsApp group, if you're not part of my WhatsApp group, please click and join over here. And this is the Facebook group where you can join, right? And also I would suggest that please, sometimes the mails goes to the spam. So move the mails from the spam to the, primary inbox, so that you can get the mails over there. Right. So, Savi, the very reason as to why you should look into the tax part of it is raise a red flag, right? If a company doesn't have the right objective of paying the taxes, right, that questions the integrity of the company, right? So please understand, it's all about a feeler about the company. You're trying to feel what the company is like, what is values and stuff like that, right? So that is the precise reason as to why you should take on the tax part of it as well. This is my way of looking into things. You may disagree or agree, whatever, right? But this gives you a perspective that, okay, this guy, and if it is quite low, then it helps you to dig deep in terms of what they are doing different compared to the industry standards, or if they have got some benefits, what sort of benefits. So that helps you getting into more level of questions, you know. So that's the way it helps, right? So please join the WhatsApp group and the Facebook group, guys. And there I'll be sharing across the recordings. Please go through the earlier recordings if you have liked this one and you have missed out on the earlier recordings. So slide one, how to collect financial data in seconds. So Bhuvan, it was not a this thing, it was a screener.in. I showed you the website. So if you go over there and place any name over here, right? So say Avanti Feeds, you go over there, right? Avanti Feeds come up and you click on export to Excel. So that is how you get the data. Nitin, I would say if you can break it up into standalone, right, that is the best way of going about, because then you understand also how things are flowing from one unit to the other, right? So the more you can do analysis on a standalone basis, right? So suppose if you are doing a study for ITC. Now, ITC company has various layers to it, right? Different nature of businesses. So if you are studying everything together, then it gets to be difficult also on many things, and you won't be able to do justice to the study that you are doing, because each type of business is very, very different from each other. A hotel industry is very it's very different from the cigarette industry that they are into, right? So if you are trying to get the breakup and doing it on standalone basis, that would be better. Yeah, that is one of the methods, Bhuvan. But I'm saying it's not from a valuation perspective I'm trying to answer the question. I'm trying to answer the question more from understanding the business. Please understand valuation, or these are all techniques, right, of how to come up with a value. But then you need, if your input is wrong, then your valuation is going to be wrong, right? So you put right inputs. That is what I'm trying to be sharing across with you guys who have commented in my this thing. So it's a five-star hotel. So if you know how a five-star hotel assumption sheet looks like, guys, you still have time. You guys who have not commented, please comment on LinkedIn and I'll share this. And this is something which you won't find anywhere, you know, in how detailed the way you have to look into the business side of it. So once you look into the different elements around this business and how it's all computed and how it all flows in, then only you get the real understanding. Then that is how you build your assumptions shift, the better it is, the rest of the computation flows from there. And there are different techniques in which you do different computations for different purposes. But if it's garbage in, then it's garbage out, right? So that is where I'm coming from. The most important thing is to analyze the business. That is something that you guys have to. Right, guys, anyone interested for the what do you call that, which I call the, what was the name given, Moise, are you there? Live Gyan, Arin's Sinning Talks. Yeah, Nitin says Arin's Sinning Talks, right? So guys, are you interested? So guys who are joining for the first time, other than this set of things that I discussed, I also, at the end, it is for those who are interested. Otherwise, in context of this, it's done for me. What was the objective of today's discussion? I hope it made sense to you. And so if you are interested on the life part of it, because I always believe that success is a function of skill and will, right? So skill is the part which I discussed earlier, and the will is the mindset part, because irrespective of how much of skill you have, if you are not working well on the mindset part of it, then things are not going to work, right? And no one teaches us this, right? In our school days, in our college days, hardly any people who actually teach us on this sort of stuff. So I'm not a life guru, a life coaching guru or something like that. But yeah, I've learned a lot of things a very hard way, and which I don't want you guys to make mistake on, and which I think about sharing. Right, this is for guys who are joining me for the first time. So I hope I have your consent on this, and then I can discuss on that. So give me a quick K if you'd be interested. Kavita says A, Moise says A, woman says yes. Only three guys. Darpin says A, Neera says yes. भाई चार पांच जन के लिए तो नहीं करेंगे. अभिषेक says 4A. Chal, okay. So guys, today I'd like to discuss as to why people don't take actions, right? So because see, whatever nothing happens is due to the fact that someone is not really taking the action. Okay, I think you, I've not shared it just a second. So the very reason as to why something doesn't happen for an individual, or they don't taste the success that they are looking for, is due to the fact that they are not taking actions, right? So as there is a saying, I hope you guys have heard it, if, it's not about doing different things, but doing things differently, right? So we all have the same number of hours, same time, same everything. So it's not about doing different things, but doing things differently. And that leads to the thought that if we want to do differently and we need to do something to really make things good for us, then what stops us, right? Why we don't take actions? So we need to understand which are those seven reasons for, just a second. So what I'm going to discuss is the seven reasons for no actions today, right? Because this is very important, because if no one is taking an action, then nothing is going to work, right? So guys, the first reason as to why we generally see someone is not taking action is something which is called autonomous, right? Autonomous kya hai? What is autonomous? Someone can say, what do I mean when I say autonomous? Independent, boring. Nee, boring to nahi hai, file. Repetitive in nature. Okay. Or koi someone else also try other than Bhuvan and file. Are you guys there? Independent, Jyoti says. So let me tell you, so autonomous, I'm using the word in this context that there is autonomy over there. So some people have said something to be done. It's been imposed upon you and you are just following it and doing it, right? So this is not something which you are very much eager to do. Say something like tax filing. So if given a chance, अगर कल गवर्नमेंट बोले कि भाई टैक्स फाइल नहीं करना पड़ेगा, कोई करने नहीं जाएगा टैक्स फाइलिंग, because it's a very boring sort of an activity and ask guys who are doing their own business, right? So I hope you are getting from where I'm coming up, right? So work like that, which has been imposed upon you and you are not liking to do that, that is something which I am placing it under the broader head of autonomous, right? Now let us understand the second aspect. The second aspect, which I think Payal said correctly, the second aspect is something which is boring, right? So you don't like doing the set of thing, right? And see, when I'm discussing this, with this context also, that whether this world of finance is at all for you. Because see, everyone cannot be like, everyone won't like engineering, everyone won't like chemistry, everyone won't like physics, like some people like it, someone don't, right? So similarly, it's not that everyone would like finance or would like to get into investment banking, right? Because there's a nature of work that one needs to do. And for some people that may be very exciting, and some people it may be very boring as well, right? So how do you know whether the work is interesting or boring in the first place? So for that, you have to expose yourself, right? So that is where I'm coming from. But before that, as I say, whoever has attended my webinar, so in any management consulting firm, they apply a concept called MESI, mutually exclusive, collectively exhaustive set of events. So we are not going to think as to whether this is applicable for me or not. But the question is, what are those elements, right, for which a person doesn't take action? So the first one is autonomous. The second one is boring. The third is, which I say something called as consequences. So the thing that you are thinking about doing, so it is something like this. The graph goes like this. So say at the initial stage, you are at this stage of life, and you are not doing something. So because you, in the short term, there may not be major consequences. It's like chal jayega, matlab ye 3-4 saal to aur bhi chal jayega. Right? But if you start taking actions now, then what will happen over a period of time? Fir ek samay aayega jaisa ye bahut farak ho jayega. So this may be a short-term consequence jisme zyada kuch farak nahi hota hai, but in a long term, there may be a huge consequence that may flow up because of the effort that you have placed over here. Right? So people don't understand what sort of a consequence is going to come up at a later part of their life, because they are not able to see that, and that's the reason they are not really taking the action. So the fourth is, they don't have the confidence in the first place, right? Ki bhai mera confidence hi nahi hai jo main karne ka soch raha hu. I don't have the confidence kyun nahi hai? Because I don't see a end to end sort of a thing. Matlab main ye karunga to main कहाँ शुरू कहाँ खत्म वही क्लियर नहीं है मेरे पास, और ये मैं खुद कर पाऊंगा कि नहीं वो भी एक क्वेश्चन होता है, राइट? कि वेदर दिस इज समथिंग विच आई बी एबल टू डू, राइट? सो आई विल टेल अबाउट इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट यू शुड बी डूइंग इन दिस सेट ऑफ सिचुएशंस, बट नाउ आई एम ट्राइंग टू बॉइल डाउन इन टू द फैक्टर्स एज टू व्हाई पीपल डोंट टेक एक्शंस, राइट? सो द फोर्थ इज कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं है. द फिफ्थ इज something which is called the distance, right? So distance is like you are, I must say, it is a sort of a something with which you have not been in touch for a certain period of time, right? And so abhi is because you are not in touch for with a subject or mode of study. Maybe you have not studied only for some years. You have lost the habit of doing that, right? Or you are not into studying of certain things which you need to do at this point of time, but you are studying something very different, right? So you are distant from that, right? So that may be another reason as to why someone is not taking action. Am I making sense, guys? Give me a quick A in the chat box if I'm making sense till this point of time. Right? ये सब कारण होता है ना, मतलब कोई आदमी स्टेप नहीं ले रहा है, एक्शन नहीं ले रहा है. दीज आर सब हम लोग को पता ही नहीं चलता कि एक्शन ले क्यों नहीं रहे हैं. सो फॉर दैट वी नीड टू फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड कि वॉट आर द रीजन एज टू वाई डू वी डोंट टेक एक्शन, राइट? Then the sixth is over here. The sixth is something which is called the some psychological fear that we have, right? Some sort of psychological fear that we have. Now, fear in what sense? Like, I'm not ready to take risk. Right, taking risk. Matlab, suppose if I am trying to do something, that may involve some amount of risk, right? Or ye jo continuous energy ya effort dena padega, I am not ready to give that. I fear that I won't be able to give that energy or effort that is required, right? Or so something of this nature, right? When we have certain fears in our mind as to why we are not taking certain actions, though we know that these sort of actions, if I take, may do good for me, but वो जो initial hesitancy होता है लोगों को, जैसे few days back, you know, I offered a program, so I was having a chat with someone. So this guy had a this thing of he has made an investment somewhere of 96,000 rupees, and he didn't get any value out of that. तो वो अभी 4,000 रुपया खर्चा करने में भी वो सोच रहा है. Right, so there is sort of a ये होता है ना, मतलब we have that elephant story, right? You know, बचपन में एक elephant circus में लेके आया, is a very मतलब infant elephant, और उसके पैर में ये लगा दिया, chain लगा दिया, और फिर he was not able to move forward. तो उसके बाद वो कितना बड़ा हो गया, लेकिन उसका दिमाग में वो अभी भी वही है कि वो chain लगा हुआ है उसका पैर में. Right, though अभी वो chain उसके सामने कुछ भी नहीं है, मतलब थोड़ा खींचेगा, he can break that barrier, but then this is a mental barrier which is there, right? So these sort of things happen due to some bad experiences which has happened in the past and stuff like that, right? And there are certain personal value system, right? So you maybe some nature of work which is there which doesn't align to your value system, right, for which you don't take action. So as per me, these are the mota mota 7 reasons as to why people don't take actions, right? Now we will discuss as to what one should be doing in each of the situations. But was it good, guys? Give me a yay in the chat box. Thoda but matlab dimag khula isme. I think many of us really don't think on these lines, right? Ki bhai hum log action kyun nahi le rahe, action le rahe usko to sochte hai, lekin आज मैंने एक वीडियो भी मेरे फेसबुक ग्रुप में लोड किया है कि इट्स अ वेरी ह्यूमरस वीडियो. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव सीन दैट वीडियो कि वी नो दैट वी शुड बी स्टडिंग बट वी आर स्टिल सिटिंग एंड इट्स अ वेरी वेरी ह्यूमरस वीडियो विच अभिषेक यू हैव सीन इट. इट वाज गुड वन राइट या सो समथिंग ऑफ दैट नेचर. वी नो दैट वी नीड टू टेक एक्शंस बट वी आर नॉट रियली टेकिंग इट. Right, so these are the various reasons of people not taking action. Now the question is, what is that one should be doing in each of these situations, right? So if it is something where it's autonomous, where it is like forced upon on you, imposed upon on you, तो तब सोचना पड़ेगा कि भाई ये हमको करना है कि नहीं है, right? If it is something related to government laws, we have to abide by that. उसमें तो कुछ कर नहीं सकते. If it's something placed by the organization, you have to abide by it. Till such time you are in that organization, you have to go abide by that. So, usme zyada kuch aap kar nahi sakte. If it is boring, if something, some work is boring for you, please guys, please don't do that, right? Mera ye courses place karne ka aur ek bhi karan ye hai at this affordable price point ki bhai tum log dekh lo ki pura tumhara exposure kitna hai, sirf 4000 rupya, right? But then you get to know what is the world of finance around, what would be the nature of work that would be expected out of. And if it is something which is not exciting for you, then please don't invest in your money of in CFA or different nature of studies where you are spending lakhs and lakhs of rupees, right? Because wo cheez it's not for you in the first place. Then please don't waste that money, right? So that is one. And second is you also have to understand that. Suppose इसमें ये nature of work में कहीं किसी तरह घुस भी गए, you have to work for so many years, 30-40 years of your life, and if it is something boring for you, then you cannot have that consistency and persistency which you require to succeed, right? So please don't get into a job which is boring for you. This is not going to really help you, right? The third is in terms of consequences, where you are not able to see the consequences in the short term, but the long term consequences are there. So over this, in this set of a situation, just give me a second, guys. So in this sort of situations, what you need to do is you need to have a discipline over there, you know, that you have to go on doing it over a period of time. Because if you know that this is where I would be coming up with a career for myself, right? And it's not a job I'm speaking. I keep on saying, guys who joined my webinar, please don't work for a job. Please work for a career, right? The problem is many people work only for a job. And the challenge is in a job sort of a situation, there may be a job which you are doing for 5-7 years. And by the time you are, say, starting at around about 24, 25, and you are 32, 33, and if this is only a job and this is not really leading into a great career for yourself, then you really get into a soup, right? So career is what? Career is something where these steps that you are taking is leading you to the greater goals that you are looking for in life. Right? If this nature of shorter activities is not really taking you to the long-term objectives that you're setting for yourself, then it's a job, it's not a career for you, right? So you have to be disciplined around that. If you really want to shine strong, right? You have to take those on those activities. As I keep on saying, matlab agar kuch leke tum seekh rahe ho, if you're learning something, if you can spend 15 minutes also in a day, please do that. Maybe you have set a target for doing 2 hours. Lekin 2 hours nahi ho raha hai, isliye kuch bhi nahi kar rahe ho. Aisa mat karo. Jitna hota hai, 15 minute, 10 minute, aadha ghanta, jitna hota hai, and keep a time schedule for yourself. In fact, I'll share across many things going forward, some sort of activity sheets which you should be doing, right? And guys, would you be interested in if I share some activity sheet so that Tejas, if you want to leave, you can. It's not mandatory for you to sit back. So don't let me hurry. You can take it at your own pace, right? So the thing is that if I share some activity sheets, I hope it would be interesting for you, right? So I'll do that. So discipline is one thing that you have to reach over there. And in terms of confidence, if you want to build confidence which you don't have, the only way for really placing across this confidence in yourself is learning, right? There is no second way around that. Till such time you are learning something which is something which you are able to build and grow and show to someone, you can never attain confidence. Right? So learning is something that is going to help you do that, right? Distancing, you have to take the trouble, that initial push, the initial motivation, as I keep on saying, distancing ka ek cheez mein bolunga ki tracking and tracking measurement on a daily basis, right? That is important, that works. Tracking measurement or something which I call the daily journaling, right? So you can have a daily journaling. So just Excel sheet mein maintain karo how you are following the stuff. So this is something which is going to help you close the distance that you have built for yourself over a period of time, right? And as far as psychological fear, see, the only way you can avoid fear is take action, right? There's no other way. If you are falling in this trap, you have to take actions. You have to ensure that fear goes, and fear would be only going if you take actions. From actions, you would get clarity, right? And the more clarity you have, the more, the less fear that you have for yourself, right? So that is how. And the last is personal value. So if it is something which doesn't align to your value system, right? Something which is a value. See, every one of us has a certain level of value system, right? So your value system may be widely different from my value system, right? So if it doesn't align to the nature of work or the activities that it involves, doesn't align to your value system, then you should never get into this nature of work, right? Then you should avoid this set of activities. So this is the set of things which I wanted to discuss as on today, right? And one more thing that I would like to show you guys is just to tell you one thing that please understand, guys, that this is a write-up of Satya Nadella. I hope you know who he is. He is basically, I think it's open. Right. So this is a letter which Satya Nadella is CEO of Microsoft, right? So he has written a letter to all employees, right? And what if you see what he has written over here, you should see is that many who know me say I also defined by my curiosity and thirst for learning. This is very, very important. I buy more books than I can finish. I sign up for more online courses than I can complete, right? So I fundamentally believe that if you are not learning new things, you stop doing. And this is something which I also believe in. Like today, I am doing something for my interest along with my son, learning something around DJ, right? I have joined in something around script writing, right? I have joined something around cryptocurrency. So there are a lot of things I know. Maybe I won't be doing justice to this. I may not be 100% in everything. But the thing is, please understand this way, that if you reach 50, 60% of this set of things also, or 40%, whatever. Whatever is ahead of zero is something that you have learned aage bada life mein, right? So see it from that perspective rather than thinking ki kabhi kabhi aadmi ye soch ke shuru nahi karta hai ki bhai main pura khatam nahi kar paunga. अरे भाई पूरा नहीं पड़ेगा, होगा तो 70% करेगा, 60% पड़ेगा, उतना तो तू लाइफ में आगे बढ़ा है ना. आज जैसे आई नो डीजे में हम लोग तो फर्स्ट क्लास हुआ, उसमें भी कितने सारे दिस डब फेस, दिस लाइफ ऑफ दिस एम्बियंस, दिस टेक्नो इलेक्ट्रो, कितना किस्म का डीजे में म्यूजिक पैटर्न्स होता है, which I was totally aware of. Not aware of, right? So there is something which I got to know over here. Right, so I think these are those elements which people who succeed, they think about in this way, and which many people don't think in this manner, and that's the reason they don't succeed, right? So or don't take action. So ye bolna tha aaj. I hope it makes sense to you guys. I would obviously improve over a period of time in the way I communicate all these things, but I think the message is passed on, right? Give me an A in the chat box, guys, if it added value to you. I just want you guys to think in a different way. The problem is many people don't take action just for this small way of looking at life. And that's why they don't aim to get the success that they are designing for themselves, right? So next week, what I'll do, I'll try to share some templates with you guys, some sort of a structure which would make your activities more tangible and which will help you think through around things. Which I would be doing that, right? So guys, I hope the last one and almost 2 hours have been fruitful for you, and in terms of your learning over there and this as well. Yeah, Abhishek, what was your question? Just let me know. Abhishek, please understand, you need to understand whoever is teaching and what skills you are building in the process, right? If you think that you are don't go by the names, right? It has nothing to do with the name, but rather the person who is placing across the thing, what he or she is teaching, right? And what sort of end objectives you are trying to attain, right? And that is something which you have to do rather than usko, matlab you should have ways and means to know. You can take reference of people who have undertaken those programs, right? Or what they have to say around this, right? You have to do some research around that. The world, like, we are all research guys, right? So we need to know how to research around things, and then if we think that this is worth investing, so there is no direct answer to this question, you know. So there is no direct answer to this. If you think that it is worth investing in that, like, why do you think I am doing conducting this webinar? So that you guys know about me, right? right? And I also give you some clarity as to what, where is the missing link, right? So it should be a win-win at the end of the day, that I also gain something out of this exercise that I am placing across, and you also gain something out of it, right? So every relationship, which I keep on saying, has to be a win-win relationship, whether it's with your spouse, with your faculties, with your customers, with your boss, right? So neither of the relationship work. If it's win-lose or lose-win, neither of the relationship work. So if you think that sort of a win you are able to create for yourself, for the energy, money, and the time that you are going to devote, right? And how do you get assured of the fact that whether you'll win at the end of the day? That is where you have to research it well. You have to find people who have really succeeded. Just don't go by the brand name. That is what I would say. Yeah, so Abhishek, let me tell you, which I told you last day also, which I still clearly remember. See, no price is high or low in life. It's all about what you make out of that investment. There are two ways of looking at it, right? Whether you are doing an investment or you are, it's an expenditure point. So if you think you are really doing an investment and you can generate returns out of that, right? Then you should, if you are, we are all finance guys, right? If you're investing 1 rupee and if we get 3 rupees, then the whole life we can go about doing that, isn't it? It's a business sense for us. So, but then you have to be assured of the fact ki maine 1 rupee diya to 3 rupee aaye mere paas. वहां पे अगर क्वेश्चन मार्क होगा देन डोंट इन्वेस्ट दैट 1 rupee. बट इफ यू बेसिस योर रिसर्च, बेसिस योर एनालिसिस, व्हाटएवर यू हैव डन, जस्ट डोंट फॉल बैक ऑन एनी ब्रांड नेम फॉर व्हेन यू आर लुकिंग फॉर जॉब. ऑल्सो डोंट फॉल बैक ऑन जस्ट द ब्रांड नेम. इफ यू हैव बीन इन माई जॉब सर्च मास्टर क्लास वेबिनार, आई डिस्कस ओवर देयर ऑल्सो, प्लीज डोंट जस्ट गो बाय द ब्रांड नेम्स. समटाइम्स द वर्क कल्चर इज सो बैड इन सम बेस्ड ऑन ब्रांड नेम्स की दिमाग खराब हो जाता है, right? So do some due diligence in terms of understanding how is the work culture over there and stuff like that. So all those things matter a lot. मतलब सिर्फ मतलब जल्दबाजी में किसी चीज में घुसो नहीं, right? And if you know that this guy is making sense, और ये भी नहीं कि decision ही नहीं ले पाते हो. अगर अभी जैसे for example, if you are not able to take a decision of investing 4000 rupees, how you think you can analyze 4000 crores ka business and 40000 crores ka business? 4000 cheez jahan pe invest karne uska hi tum analysis nahi kar pate ho, right, of someone, to tum 4000 ka bhi kaise karoge? Am I making sense, guys? Are you getting where I'm coming from? So you're able of taking decision. Sometimes we are able to analyze and come to a conclusion. लेकिन फिर वो डिसीजन मतलब वो स्टेप एक्शन नहीं ले पाते, राइट? सो ये सब जगह पे हम लोग अटक जाते हैं. सो वी हैव टू, देखो एक लेवल तक वी कैन नॉट बी एश्योर्ड ऑफ एवरीथिंग इन लाइफ, राइट? देयर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड एश्योरेंस कि 100% मुझे ये होगा. बट वही चीज में लास्ट बार इसलिए बोला था, इफ यू रिमेंबर, कि 10 डिसीजन लोगे तो 2 में गलती होगा, ठीक है, हो गया है लाइफ में. लेकिन 8 का जो फायदा हुआ वो 2 के चक्कर में तुम वो 8 में मत अटक जाओ. There's a reason as to why I've said it in my last webinar, right? So the more I keep on discussing, you'll understand where I'm coming from. वो दो के चक्कर में ना कभी कभार वो आठ और अच्छा जगह you miss on. I've invested in so many programs myself also in various places, right? I also need to learn. I also need to upskill myself. बट देन ऐसा क्या कि हर जगह से अच्छा मुझे ये मिला, सीखने को मिला? या देखो कुछ ना कुछ तो हर जगह पे सीखने को मिलता है. ऐसा अभी तक मेरे लाइफ में ऐसा नहीं हुआ कि कुछ भी नहीं सीखने को मिला, ऐसा नहीं होता है. हाँ, यू कैन से कि मैं इतना इन्वेस्ट किया, इतना रिटर्न्स मिला कि नहीं. सो कभी कभार ऐसा होता है कि नहीं उतना मिला, तो दैट्स ओके, दैट्स फाइन, भूल जाओ और आगे बढ़ो एंड टेक अनदर कॉल. लाइफ में यू शुड हैव कॉन्फिडेंस ऑन योरसेल्फ कि भाई मैं जो डिसीजन ले रहा हूँ, नहीं तो तुम स्टॉक में भी कैसे इन्वेस्ट करोगे? वहां पर भी कोई एश्योरेंस है कि तुमको, तुम वॉरेन बफेट भी नहीं बोल सकता है कि 100% एश्योरेंस कि ये स्टॉक में, वो कभी बोलेगा नहीं ये बात, क्योंकि उसको पता है कि तुम, इट्स अ गेम ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी, राइट? सो यू मे हैव 100% प्रोबेबिलिटी, बट दैट स्टिल इज अ प्रोबेबिलिटी एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. यू आर गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से? सो सो डोंट थिंक ऑन दोज लाइन्स. करो जितना जितना तुमको लगे, पढ़ो, सोचो, अंडरस्टैंड करो, लोगों के से मिलो जो पहले किया है, टेस्टिमोनियल्स देखो लोग क्या बोलते हैं, फिर देन कम टू अ कंक्लूजन. बट या डोंट जस्ट गो बाय द नेम्स फॉर श्योर, बिकॉज देयर आर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हु आर जस्ट दे आर व्हाट दे आर डूइंग इज दे आर जस्ट ब्रांडिंग देमसेल्व्स एंड सेलिंग प्रोडक्ट्स इन द मार्केट, राइट. सो सी आई ऑलवेज हैड अ चॉइस, यू नो, कि ये मेरा जो एफर्ट है मैं किसी के साथ ज्वाइन कर लूँ. Right? You won't find my programs in Udemy. I could have uploaded the programs and I could go to many more countries. Right? मुझे कुछ करने ही नहीं पड़ेगा, सिर्फ videos upload कर दूंगा वहाँ पे. But I'm consciously not going over there for the sole reason that I want to place my own stuff in my own way. I do not want to be getting into one among the many sort of a thing. I want to have my own niche. Stuff and whoever relates to me, my way of thinking, my way of doing things, I'll attract my own tribe, right? I don't need to. That's my way of looking at things. I hope I'm making sense, guys. Just कुछ ज़्यादा ही बोल दिया लगता है. Not getting any response in the chat box. So, did it make sense, guys? What I said just now? Just let me know. Yeah. दीज आर सोचने का तरीका होता है, एक एक जन एक एक तरीके से सोचता है. ठीक है गाइज, गुड नाइट. आई होप टूडे इट वॉज गुड. सही बोलो, मतलब ये फाइनेंशियल एनालिसिस वॉज इट गुड, बिकॉज देन इफ यू फाइंड दिस गुड देन आई मूव इन टू द नेक्स्ट लेवल्स ऑफ डीपर एनालिसिस ऑफ थिंग्स, राइट. आई रियली वॉन्ट सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्रू फीडबैक फ्रॉम यू गाइज, राइट. Kavita says very good. Suparna says yes. What about others? अच्छा नहीं है तो भी बोलो, अच्छा है तो भी बोलो, मतलब कुछ तो बोलो. कोई कुछ बोल ही नहीं रहा है, सब लिखने में बिजी है क्या? Yes, Satendra, I'll share the recording so you'll get that. Mohit says yes. Towards investing in equity from traditional investment for that long is we have to understand function management. Yeah, absolutely. Dekho, the set of things that I'm discussing, obviously one has to be acquainted with a P&L management and cash flow, right? So utna to expectation hai. In fact, in engineering colleges also, I think there is a finance section where people discuss around financial statements. तो उतना आज के दिन सभी का होता है, जो भी invest भी करते हैं market में, how they do if they don't have any understanding around the financials, right? So that's something which more or less people have. Right thing that we are facing now is, you know. Satendra, I didn't understand your statement. Neeraj joined late, okay. So Neeraj, you can find my recordings, so you can go through that, right? Satendra, I'm just waiting for your response, and then I'll call it a day today. I hope we are studying this. Taranvind, accounting policies are different in different places, right? So don't worry about accounting policies. That's what I'm saying. You have to get into an orientation that you are learning finance, right? Which is different from accounting, right? So yahan pe we need not be very specific around numbers. Here we are taking decisions on a number of factors, which includes economic analysis, industry analysis, company analysis, right? So think from that perspective. Wo wala maturity law. Don't get into technicalities around accounting standards and stuff like that. Janna acha hai, but utna bhi nahi to only chartered accountants could have studied finance. That's not the case, right? Engineers also studied finance and they have never studied accounting standards, right? So that's why I'm saying ki finance is way different from accounting. So get into that mindset of studying. When finance padho to finance mindset se padho, I have seen many people cannot shift themselves from that accounting wala perspective to finance. So finance is a lot different from the normal accounting that we generally get exposed to. Right? Okay, guys. Thanks for joining, and see you in the next webinar. Right, good, Mohis. Good. Okay, guys, thanks a lot, and we'll join again on Friday, right? Bye, good night.